Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, the internet's busiest music nerd. Hope you're doing well. This video, as you can already guess, is about how artists should manage failure, an unhappy audience, a bad reception on a new song or a record. Look guys, what has partially inspired me to do this video is seeing Chance the Rapper hop onto Twitter and wrestle a little bit internally with some of the negative reactions to his latest full-length album, The Big Day. And Chance is not alone. He's in a position that many artists have been in over the years, where you come out with your first record that has disappointed a vast majority of your audience, or is at least not pleasing a large number of people. And look, if you're in the music industry for any extended period of time, this is an eventuality. It's going to happen at some point. You can't please all the people all the time, even if there are some moments in your career where it seems like you're doing it and you're on track to continue doing it. It's an impossibility. Let's get into some of these points. I do want to first say, though, if your attitude going into this is, Anthony, what do you know? You're just some asshole reviewer. How do you have any perspective on this? So on and so forth. If you think that, that's fine. I don't disagree with you. I am just a reviewer. You know, I'm not Chance the Rapper at the end of the day. So, you know, if that's what you think, then don't watch the video. If you think my advice is worth nothing, then that is what it is. But if you're interested in this, then here we go. Number one that we have over here, we have don't get discouraged. Do not get discouraged. Okay? And I'm not saying this to people who have not quite gotten their music career booted up yet. You know, if you're already in the industry and you're making waves and you're doing well and you've been killing it and you've hit this bump in the road, do not get discouraged, because that is basically you actively axing your own career. The moment you get discouraged and the moment you give up and the moment you decide, well, because of the negative reception of this album, it's not worth it anymore, I'm not going to do it. Once you've made that decision, you have essentially decided it's done with. It's kaput. You are killing. You are smothering your own career. Do not let the negativity drive you to that decision. It is not worth it. If you still love music, if you still want to put out music, do not allow the negative reception of one album or one song discourage you. Do not get discouraged. That is number one. That is key. Okay. Number two, don't let the hate or negativity consume you. Don't let it distract you, and do not let it seep into your music. I swear to God, Logic would be making great music by now, and memes like, oh, he's biracial, would have completely evaporated by now, if not for the fact that Logic keeps putting it in his music. He keeps addressing it. He keeps making it apparent that he is letting it get to him, and that's the thing. Failure for a lot of people on the internet is a spectacle. Having acknowledged that fact, do not allow that to consume you, consume your music, consume your public image. Don't allow it to destroy you, because here's the thing. If you allow the process to happen, you allow people to live out their lives, you live out your life, and you just keep concentrating on something else, this will eventually pass, or at least reach a level where it's easy to ignore. It's not that big an issue. You can continue on doing what you're doing successfully without it impeding you or getting in the way. So do not let it stop you. Do not let it consume you or affect your music in a negative way. I understand wanting to address real life issues that you're going through in your songs, but if you are going to do that, do your best to go about it in such a clever way that it's just like one mention and it's done. You've made your point. It's a great point. People remember it. And you don't need to go on and on and on about it over again to readdress it, because your original mention of it
sufficed.
Moving on from there, defend your work if you must. I understand in the age of social media, it is tempting and it is in some cases even desirable to hop online and say, hey, you guys hate my album, or repeat the memes people are throwing at you. Just do anything to respond to the hate, because you feel like it needs responding to. But if you're going to do that, if you're going to go down that road, which generally I would recommend against. But if you're going to go down that road, do not add fuel to the flames. Do not go about it in such a way where you are trying to like beg people for sympathy, or you are just generally adding to the spectacle. Don't become a spectacle. Don't add to the spectacle. What you need to appreciate is that people's memories are not all that long these days. People's attention spans are shorter than ever. Take advantage of that by just allowing time and allowing preferably a more quality album down the road to just wash over people and just put a better impression on listeners down the road. Moving on from there, move on and concentrate on your next project. That's another piece of advice I would most definitely lay on you, because listen, here's the thing. As a musician, as a commercial artist, what people know you most for is your music. And in the music industry, audiences are most interested in, okay, you know, I like you, but what have you done for me lately? And if what you've done for them lately is good, then their opinions of you will shift, even if they do have some negative perceptions of some stuff that you've done in the past. It may require a lot of work. It may require a lot of focus. It may require you biting your tongue for a long time. It may require you picking up the broken pieces of your career, of your ego, whatever. But the only thing that's truly going to wash out the memory of a bad project is a good project. There's literally nothing you're going to be able to say in an interview, in a tweet, in a Tumblr post that's going to just totally shift the tide of negativity against this music that people don't like in the other direction. So truly and honestly, a new project, a better project, is essentially the remedy for a bad one. Moving on to the next one. Ooh, this one is important. Don't take it personally. It is not personal, because no one who is critiquing your music, even if they're going as far as to attack you or make fun of you or make memes about you, it is not personal because they do not know you personally. Even if you do feel like your music is a personal endeavor that you put your mind and body and soul into, I mean, not really, because those things for the most part are being talked about in a figurative sense, but still, I understand the personal and emotional connection that one has to something they created, and then seeing a bunch of people rip it apart and tear it apart and hate on it, so on and so forth. I get that. I understand that. But as tempting as it is to look at it as a personal attack, as an affront to you personally, it is not. It is not. It is not. It is not. To the average listener on the internet, you are but a vessel or an output for them to essentially just plug into and get out of you what they want. I mean, I know that sounds really cold. I know that sounds really indifferent, but unfortunately, that is what commercial music does. That is what the music industry does. It commodifies art. It commodifies emotion. And if you are getting negativity from fans or other listeners on a record, all they're really telling you is that I'm a consumer. I want a certain thing. You did not give me that certain thing. And while it may hurt to hear that, and it may not feel very good to get that message thrown at you, that's all they're communicating to you. There's no real true depth to what they're demanding of you. Ultimately, all they want is a piece of entertainment that they enjoy. Do not allow fans to trick you, and don't allow yourself to be tricked as a fan by the fact that you enjoy an artist's music so much, and you've researched them, and you feel like you've, you know, grown up listening to their music, and their music is an important part of your life. That's fine. And that's good. But that does not mean you know the artist. And do not allow the fact that you've been listening to an artist for a very long time allow you to feel like you are in the power position to comment on their stuff in a way where you could be like, man, I'm disappointed in you. I used to look up to you, bro. That is such a weak freaking point of view. And that is also, I think, a really unhealthy relationship dynamic between artist and consumer, frankly. It's amazing if an artist's music speaks to you, but listen, you're not Chance the Rapper's mom or dad. There's no real true way, in my view, that you could be disappointed in them on a personal level. I'll wrap up this point saying that fans are important, and artists and content creators love their fans. But look, when they are unhappy with something that you've done, it's not the same thing or worse than like your uncle or your siblings being unhappy with some horrible thing that you've been caught doing. It's not the same thing. Don't let it cut that deep. Next one is, remember that people will eventually forget, that I sort of went over earlier on a previous point a bit, but it is worth mentioning again. People will eventually forget. The audience's attention span collectively is very, very short. The intensity of the criticisms and the memes will eventually fade with time, and they will fade even faster with a new and a better project. The only way they will hold on to these criticisms is if you hold on to the hatred and the unhappiness that you have over their dislike for this album that you've just made. I will say, in my own case, there are a lot of very negative reviews that people really disagree with me on that I've done over the years. But the reason a lot of that has stuck around is because, one, I still hold a lot of those opinions and routinely defend them if people do bring them up. But on top of that, I mean, the mentions of these are nowhere near as intense as they were when I initially put out the review. The fact that I've been able to continue on just putting out one piece of content after another, giving people other perspectives, other reviews, allows the audience to take in something else and basically, I don't know, allow it to just fade into the background. I think that is the final bit of advice here in this series, how artists should manage failure. These are obviously not everything that I think could be said. I think there are some commercial or semi-professional artists out there in the music world who may be able to speak to some other points related to this issue, but at least as an outsider, as an audience member, someone who routinely sees artists get torn up over and over and over on albums that they release that the audience that they typically cater to did not enjoy, to me, these are the pitfalls that I see people fall into again and again and again as they continue to receive this negativity and put out music that elicits negative reactions. All right, I think that is going to be it. Thank you very much, everyone, for watching. Let me know if down in the comments any of this helped you, and you are the best. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. There is also a link down below to our Patreon page where you can get some extra content. And yeah, that's all. Anthony Fantano, How Artists Should Manage Failure, forever.